Welcome back.
Hey.
To Crushing Bros.
Ready to crush this entire planet.
Crush 40. Live and learn. Breakdancing. Breakdancing.
We're almost.
Welcome.
We're almost ready to actually start playing Final Fantasy 15.
So now a new component's been introduced. We have a car. For the sake of interesting feats, I am going to keep fast travel to a minimum.
Just because you want to see the scenery?
Yeah.
I'm into that. It never takes more than a minute or two to travel. At least at this early in the game.
Usually.
Once we've driven everywhere once, we can probably start fast traveling.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's get some good driving music, shall we?
Hammerhead is like no garage.
The fucking,
you know,
fucking battle theme, dude. No less of purveyors to I love this game.
I'll miss it once this road trip's over with.
Look how fucking sick this looks. Reason
you can't. It looks great. Visit any, you should get a Porsche. Keys.
I'm sure Cindy will be glad. Do you know how badly I want this car?
So you want? Like, you mean like
I want the Regalia? It's not a real car, but I want one so badly.
How did they make that? Seems like such a fuck up on their part. How did they make how did they make the Kingsglaive car and not the Regalia? I bet you they were like, "Hey Audi, you want to make us a car for this?"
They made the Regalia the Kingsglaive car, not this car.
What?
They didn't even make the fucking.
That's what I'm saying. They made. Why didn't they do that?
I don't know.
It seems like they should have made this car first.
Right. Look, if any of you guys at home, for some weird ass reason, are like car enthusiasts and you build cars for a living or shit, build for me a plan, because I want a Regalia and I want friends.
You want friends?
I want to cosplay as these boys in a Regalia.
You just want to go on a real Final Fantasy road trip.
Yeah. Bone dry. Don't you?
It would be great. I don't need to. I don't feel the need to dress like. Which one would I even be?
When you want to, you probably Ignis.
Ignis? I'll take Ignis.
Because you like, you love cooking.
I would take Ignis over. I don't. I refuse to believe that I'm the Prompto of any group.
I don't think you're Prompto. TOVG. TOVG.
TOVG Prompto?
No, like TOVG.
Final Fantasy. Yeah.
I'd probably be Noctis.
Yeah. I'll be Ignis.
You'd be Ignis. I would say Frasier is our Prompto, but Frasier's not here anymore.
Ted is the Prompto now.
Ted is Prompto?
Ted is Prompto, and Pat is Gladio. It's pretty solid.
Not bad.
Just a sec. Yeah.
No, hold on. Forgot Al's in play.
Ooh.
Al would be Prompto.
Al would be Gladiolus.
You think he'd be he would be Gladiolus.
Yeah.
That's right.
He's Al is Gladiolus.
Oh, yeah. Pat can be the Regalia. Our faithful car.
I have a faithful
the Regalia.
That's not all.
So what about Sid?
I want you to
what about any other human characters?
Are you kidding? Pat keeps us alive.
He scares the monsters away when we drive around at night.
It's come time for me to leave Tenebrae. Finally get to see after all these years.
Got it.
Got it.
You went with the sentimental option.
Yes, I always do. I try and play the character.
A lover, not a fighter. I feel like Noctis is reluctant to meet her, but maybe I'm crazy.
No, they've known each other for years.
I know, but
I think, you know, I think Noctis's secret fear is he's afraid of being a bad husband. I think that's all it is.
I feel like he has problem expressing how he truly feels.
What was that about? You don't say.
To be fair, Prompto, that is definitely one of the weirdest mechanics of this entire video game.
The dog?
That dog.
So, for the sake of time, I'm not going to be getting any of the question marks unless required for us.
Okay.
Just for now.
We might as well just play through the story. Why not?
Right.
But I think we have to take this one. Oh, no. We can just go straight to Golden Key?
Everything in order.
Let's do it. Yep. Dude. Another thing I want to talk about in this game that I like fucking love about this game is like, check out what traveling feels like in this game compared to like Skyrim. They actually made it enjoyable to sit in a car in a video game.
Lady Luna Freya of Tenebrae has issued an official statement regarding the forthcoming treaty.
This happens from time to time.
I cannot express the joy in my heart on receiving word of this coming peace, nor the pride I take in my betrothal, playing a part in this historic moment. On this joyous occasion, some have voiced cause for concern. The fear I will be unable to fulfill my duties as Oracle. Please rest assured, my marriage will not stand in the way of my calling. You will find me in your towns and villages, as you always have, and I shall continue to bless you all.
I can't believe this is actually this video game.
From Tenebrae for her wedding ceremony in the coming days. Please be advised that during this time alone, her duties as Oracle will be suspended.
It's in the treaty?
Of course. Simple formality.
Course.
One of those symbol of the peace deals.
So it's more like a marriage of convenience.
A ladyship seems nevertheless amenable to the prospect. And Noctier likes the idea.
Does he?
What's that? I do? Buzz off.
Got him.
I think Noctis actually loves Lady Luna
Freya.
I'm
sure he does. I think
he feels pensive because she doesn't love him.
I think it's just like he doesn't want them to be like, oh, gay. You know what I mean?
Go for a dip.
That a big? I think he's just afraid. It's like the stuff you feel when you're with the boys.
Nobody goes to
like, you don't want to seem like weak.
Sure.
You know that thing where they're like, ooh, he's in love.
Right.
You wanna like have those feelings, but also like still seem awesome. You know what I mean?
I'm the king of cinematic driving.
Aren't there even more cinematic camera angles? Isn't there one that's like on the bumper?
Might want to stock up on potions and stuff.
Nice. You're being helpful for a change.
What do you mean for a change?
That joke gets funnier and funnier each time that it happens in this game.
So
we gotta go. What is this?
Getting an item, you know, because we need items.
Do we?
No.
Do we still have all? Oh.
Whoa.
Do we still?
That's never happened before to me.
Yeah, never once. Have we already gotten all the items?
In the game?
Like. Do we still have all the items that you had when you reset the game?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I have everything.
Is this place amazing?
Literally?
Well, I don't have the new game plus items or the secret items you get on the game. Like there's good first impression. In the guide, there's like marked off green items you can go get.
Right.
I don't have them because I just jumped to new game plus.
Right, because those are still on the map because you haven't wrapped around to post beating the game.
Yeah.
Got it. Or have you? To Golden... Not really.
I'm afraid you're out of luck.
You're the worst pirate I've ever seen.
Bring you here.
Or heard of.
Well,
I'll
not take you for.
But you have heard of me.
And what's your story? I'm an impatient traveler, ready to turn ship. The ceasefire's getting us nowhere.
Question of the day. What do you think about this guy? If you haven't played Final Fantasy 15, question of the day, what do you think about this guy? Souvenir. They make those? At this point in the game, I want to hear what people who are playing this game for the first time think of this guy at this point in the game.
And who's
what do you think his deal is?
A man of no consequence.
That's the question of the day. What's this guy's deal?
Yeah, right.
Actually, more accurately, it's what do you think this guy's deal is going to be?
You believe what that guy said about the port being closed?
I'm skeptical, although I won't discount the possibility.
I say we go check it out for ourselves.
This is such a, like, Final Fantasy location, like, modern Final Fantasy location.
Right.
I don't know what it is about it, but it just feels like it could be in, like, any of the Final Fantasies. Maybe not 9, but, like, 7, 8, 9, 10... Type 0, like, 13, 14. It looks like it could be in, like, any game. It even looks like it could be in 14.
The Empire.
given strict orders.
Probably is a place in 14.
Yeah. This guy is the worst.
Shame if you were late to your own wedding, right, Prince Noctis?
Why did they decide, like,
pleasure?
Okay, like, voice acting choices. Let's look at this guy. What do we think? Who was, like, I'm thinking, like, middle-aged, like, New Jersey plumber.
Who looks like one of us, though?
He looks like a K-pop, like, pretty boy. Like, the pretty one in the K-pop band. And he's like, I'm Dino! What are you doing here?
I have no idea.
What do you want?
I knew you'd come around.
Come by and have some gabagool with me and the wife!
I'm gonna extort the chair to you, okay with that?
Yeah.
Marked where you need to go on your map. All you gotta do is find me some rough gemstones.
I hate thinking you're not getting fed out there. Come on by, have a home-cooked meal! Don't,
and the papers will run you out of town. Capiche?
Wow, what an asshole. I didn't realize how much of a dick he was.
He's like an extortionist. He's like, I'm gonna fucking ruin your shit if you don't, like, go get me jewels.
He's really got your number, Nox.
Huh. Not like we made much effort to keep it secret.
Even if we had, the press always finds a way. We needn't befriend him, but we'd best not make him our enemy.
They're like, oh shit, that guy is fucked up. Let's be careful. No, 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 no. Waste of time.
That's the cat. You're right.
A fish for a cat right now?
So,
No.
I do need a fish.
Oh my god.
Right?
Do you have, like, at least, like, some good ass fishing rod so that maybe you'll catch, like.
Oh, fuck yeah, I do.
Can you possibly, like, maybe catch some.
In 2 seconds? Yeah. Yes.
How does it feel now that it's finally.
We might as well show him the fucking fishing.
I guess.
Come on. You can't fool me. Any guy would be over the moon to marry her.
No big deal.
Yeah,
did you realize that we're just doing what they're doing? We're like, do we think he wants to marry her or not? And they're just like, you're ready to get married. He's like, I don't know if I am.
Hey, buddy. What's up? Taking a little stroll?
Yeah. I'm hungry.
You must be hungry.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Hold on a sec. I'll find you something.
Okay.
Oh, gotta come up
hurry.
With some kind of food.
Could I'm really hungry.
Or we could fish for some.
Excellent idea. Let's go.
Hell yeah.
You should just walk over to that restaurant.
This one's perfect.
Walk up to the counter and say, one fish, please.
Oh. Is it? No, fuck me.
Here you go. Come
it's just giving him one of the fish I caught.
What? You don't like fish?
Oh my god, so we don't even get a fish?
You only like
so now we have to go take it to the fucking restaurant to get it. Oh my god, or it's never gonna get off of our quest log.
Yeah.
And this cat's just gonna stay here forever?
Yeah.
Oh, good, let's just not do it.
I just gotta run up there and hit yaks and come back.
Cold as ice, baby. Fuck that hungry ass cat. He's not even real, let him stay there forever.
I don't know about that.
Hell yeah. Come at me. Nah, I'm just kidding you guys.
Hey, do you serve anything a cat might like?
That the best pickup line you've got?
Well, whoa!
No, I...
Whoa!
Is that really what she normally looks like?
I'm only teasing.
Yeah.
I have a feeling I know...
Listen, the lighting's a little wonky right now.
She looks like she's, like, being lit from the inside by, like, a thin layer of lights underneath her skin.
Just order the last fish on hand. Would you mind catching another one of these?
All right. It's a good thing I have plenty of fish in my inventory. You know, ones that I caught from not 100 hours of playing this game.
Great.
Not 186 hours or something like that.
You know, this is really thoughtful of you, but be warned.
Oh, why is this happening?
And they're notoriously picky.
I'll skip ahead.
We are on our way to get married to another queen. Our kingdom's future's in the balance.
I gotta feed a cat.
He was like,
for a man that used to be all about feeding that puss, I don't know what your deal
is.
Whoa! That's a reference to our multiplayer mayhem show.
Oh yeah, feed that puss. I remember that.
Yeah.
But it was wasn't his name Puss?
No, he was a cat.
Did I name him Puss?
You named him Puss.
Okay, you got me.
You're what?
I named him Puss.
Aw, I get Claude's my keeper.
Oh shit.
I just skipped him.
You're just never gonna get that experience.
Yo, you're the one who were like, skip it, so I did.
No, you're right. It's just funny.
But, now I'm gonna make you suffer a little more.
Why?
I'm gonna kiss some fish.
We're gonna kiss some fish.
Kiss some fish.
We're gonna kiss some fish.
Well, no, because I mean, our promises for this series.
We have to get to level 10. We have to get level, all the
trophies. We're gonna get all the trophies for you guys. All the trophies
are
happening.
We only have one trophy left.
Yeah.
Maybe if we just sneak it in every from time to time, it'll just slowly go up.
Right?
Just catch a fish here.
Where's the dock? Oh, it's over there.
Catch a little fish here, catch a little fish there. Here a fish, there a fish, everywhere a fish, fish.
How about this? Our rule will to catch three fish.
Yep.
Every time we find a fishing pond.
Perfect. That's a good rule.
There's not many in the game.
That's not that bad. Three fish, and you know how to fish.
Pretty easy.
Yeah, it's pretty tight. This is another thing, just like the battling, where I was like, I hate this, and now I like it.
We're going to try our best.
You have, like, weak-ass...
Oh, you're right. Well, let's see.
Did everybody in the group just yawn? Hey. Doesn't that look tasty?
What was that?
What was that? What is that? I wonder if His Majesty fished as well. Guys, this sounds like there's an animal somewhere in the office. I know.
So I was gonna have to do this on my own for the first time.
That was crazy. It's like sit and then like pull it a little. Then do it again. Do it again. Don't wait too long. Yep.
If the red bar goes further and further across the screen.
Oh, got him. Yeah, you just gotta be enticing without being like overly enticing, because they don't like it when they don't get to work for it a little bit. So you gotta go, yeah. Basically, it's all about just putting the rod in the opposite direction that it's pulling, or like following it, and then just reeling it in, and then not letting there be tension, and that's it. Like, Jirard has only lost like 15 durability just now. That's pretty good. Is this like a super good fishing rod?
No. I think it's the default one that the game gives me.
Well, because that shit is just not going
down. I haven't equipped it yet.
Are you reeling it in?
No, not yet.
Just reel it in. One AP. Look at that.
Huh. Great job, Noct.
Glowing barrel fish!
Whoa. Would you ever eat that?
No.
Do you think it's good to eat?
No.
Would you guys ever eat a glowing fish? Question of the day. Would you guys ever stop and grab a fresh glowing fish on your way to prom? The Mindbreaker is the first one.
Yeah. It's a good thing I've got...
Dude, Death Spin. What's up with that?
Death Spin.
Yo, Nerade?
Nerade.
Let's go. Get wrecked, fish. You guys have no hope.
Yo, I have a lot of these things. Holy shit.
Dude, it probably doesn't even matter. What the fuck is that one?
Right, that's what I'm saying. It's like hard. These are like getting specific fish.
Tidal Might Leviathan. A mysterious lure that always comes back. What?
Watch this. So now we're gonna...
Let me have a turn once in a while, huh?
Yeah, sure. Next time.
Gladio. What the fuck are you talking about? I'm the fish guy. You're the explore the environment guy.
You're the fucking walk around dude.
That's what happens. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh my god!
You did good.
It's a basic fish.
I'm like, oh my god, it's like three times the size!
We'll do one more and move on.
That was crazy. That was like cartoonishly better at- That was like a cartoonishly better fishing job.
This is like designed to catch, like, really big-ass impossible fish.
I guess. Is that something that we can be on the lookout for?
Big ass impossible fish?
Yeah, does that like get your experience like way up?
Yeah, the bigger the fish, the better.
Really?
Yeah.
So should we, like, look up a guide of, like, where the best fish are? So that when we're there, we make sure and grab them? Oh, my God.
I mean, honestly, at this point, I don't really know because the game's changed a lot.
Yeah.
I know that as a part of my completion criteria, I have to get all 100 fish in the game.
Uh-huh.
Which sucks.
That's just for you playing the completionist.
Yeah, but yeah. I think, like, from that aspect alone, I'm pretty sure that, like, there's going to be more than just that.
You see this?
Like, there'll be guides out there to, like, really optimize everything.
Right.
So, let me explain Ascension Grid real quick. So, the Ascension Grid is this beautiful-looking thing right here.
This was crazy because I was like, I'm going to be done with this, like, really
soon. No big deal. And then it opened up more and more.
Yeah.
So, there's different tabs of different skills. There's the Armiger, which is the powerful spell of the kings.
Right.
You get their weapons and they imbue you, and they're already completed this grid. Then there's the Wait Mode. Now, Wait Mode is, like, easy mode where you can...
It's not easy mode. It's more like strategy mode. It's like...
I guess so. It puts the ATB... It takes the ATB aspect back in the game.
It basically, kind of. Anytime that you're not pressing anything, it just stops, and then you can, like, choose the next thing that you're going to do, basically.
You get benefits for actually doing that, too.
I'm interested. We should, like, do that one time. We don't need to do it right now, but I just, like, want to see, like, a real battle done in
Then there's exploration, which is based on, like, giving AP and experience per character. So, like, you know... Gladio's whole thing is
once you fill out this grid, you get as much AP
as possible.
Yeah, and AP is really better than experience in this game.
Yeah,
in terms of making your characters
AP
better.
AP is like buffing your stats and your capabilities.
Yeah, I mean, you level up a little bit with your level, but it's really about using AP.
The biggest like thing of this game is the AP is easy to get, but hard for patience sake because. The end game AP items take massive amounts of AP. So, for instance, this is 555. This is 999. This one's also 99. So,
it's
not too bad.
It's basically just like you like get a bunch of stuff and then you like grind for a long time and get a few more things.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the other thing that's tight about this is that, like, in a lot of games, like Skyrim, for example, like you see this whole like skill tree in front of you and you're like, Jesus Christ, like, what do I even invest in, right?
So at this point, for this whole tree, stats is for increasing all their health and whatnot, but then the biggest one is the accessory slot. It looks like Prompto's my last boy, so I'm going to get that one.
That's a big deal.
And now Prompto can wear 3 accessories instead of 2.
Yeah, so here's the thing. So basically what that does is it keeps you from getting super powerful till super late in the game, which is awesome. But then also, like, go to some of the other ones that there are, like the Armiger one, and, like... The magic one, I think, like, a couple of the other ones, like, don't open up until you progress through the story a little bit.
It's mostly the Armiger and the magic one.
Yeah, so you think about it differently. Like, you're like, oh, I don't have to worry about this right now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to focus on these other ones. And so that way, it's not so overwhelming, and you actually level level your characters well, and it makes you actually focus. Because a lot of people who play Final Fantasy just kind of, like, grind until they're, like, too strong to have to worry about it, you know? Mm-hmm. But in this game, you really get to, like, think about how you fight. It's really cool.
Yeah, and I think for the sake of everything that's happening, I lost my train of thought. Sorry, guys. Jirard.exe has failed.
It's all right, dude. I said a lot of stuff about a lot of confusing things. I've literally never used any of their other skills ever.
Really?
Yeah. I use the ones that they start with, and I like them, and I like use them very well. I'm sure there's like better ones. Like, I know there's one that's like a heal one.
There are better. I mean, I generally, what I'll do is like, I just try and like
match it to the sitch.
Just try leveling them up. You know what I mean?
I should. I mean, like, I bet you I've probably maxed, and they all max at different levels. Is that what's up?
Yeah. Oh, I didn't even know this one existed.
So Starshell is already maxed, even though it's only level 3?
Yeah, so, they all have different capabilities.
Cool, so then...
Problem is that I'm not going to be able to use any of this stuff because I one-shot everyone, unless I wait.
Oh.
Or for hunts.
Interesting. So there is a lot of stuff you can grind out. That's interesting.
Yeah, so Impulse is like a super-duper strong attack.
Mm-hmm.
Royal Guard is like he throws his shield to protect Noctis. So everyone has different capabilities. Gladiolus is mostly designed for like AoE / protecting the prince.
Right.
Prompto or Ignis is like identifying the enemy's weakness, or like regrouping the team and healing them, or maybe like getting the team to focus one person.
Right.
Promptos are all gun, mostly all gun based, fucking around. He has a skill where he just takes a photo.
He takes like 5 pics in a battle.
Yeah. Hilarious. This one, Trigger Happy, is like, he just pulls out a bunch of guns and just starts shooting like the Matrix.
That's tight.
Yeah. I'm going to change their outfits. It's starting to really bother me.
I really hate this one. It looks very bad. Oh, man.
Oh, boy. This was the Amazon pre-order, I believe.
The casual?
Yeah.
I think I have the casual. So maybe that just comes with it.
Maybe I'll just do the regular ones for now.
They look the best in them. This is the one thing that I was a little bit bummed on about this game.
There wasn't enough outfits?
Yeah, like, if they're going to make the outfits a thing that you can change, like, and they add stats and stuff or whatever.
I would have gotten him, yeah.
They should have added, like, 35 outfits for each character. It would have been awesome.
Yeah. Anyways, back to the game.
Yeah. Yeah, guys, I promise, like, we'll finally tell you everything about this game, soon. Satisfied with Noctis' strength. You know what? Your max level. I think I'm willing to drive at night now. The car scares away any monsters that we might run into.
Mm-hmm.
We've been on move all night. Perhaps we should find a place to rest nearby.
No, shut up.
No, we are invincible, unkillable masters of
Peril
this world.
Is our middle name, then. Eh?
We're going to crush.
Yeah, it is.
No, you know what it is? Crush.
Crush is our middle name.
My name is Alexander Crush Peril Faciane.
We're going to go all the way back to here.
My name is Alexander Crush 40 Faciani.
No.
That's me.
That's horrible.
That's how I see myself now.
You're one step above delivery, boy.
Royal rank carries
this is tight. I love this look. So what I was going to say about traveling in this game is that, like, I really love, like, the idea of the car, and it, like, feels relaxing to be in the car if you want to be in the car, or you can fast travel if you want, which makes it kind of more like Skyrim, but they kind of, like, really sort of, like, with the mechanics, force you to, like, live out a road trip. Like, you have to plan, like, where you're going to sleep, like, where you're going to go. No matter what, you always have to have a plan of, like, travel. And it's really, like, a cool thing. Mm-hmm. That they did really well, and it, like, makes these types of games, like, a little easier and more, like, enjoyable to play. And I think that's really tight. I think it was important to, like, have a Japanese developer, like, try and touch this type of big open-world game in a way similar to the way that Western people do. Like... Xenoblade is really a great game, but it's so overwhelming in
all
its
right,
mechanics.
So, in the night, if you try fighting enemies, you get Big Boy showing up. I have a problem with that, though, because I'm a big boy.
The only thing is, you're 69 levels higher than him. He's going down in, like, 4 hits. So one of the things you do is you counter when you play. And there's, like, all sorts of, like, timed button presses and stuff. I don't know. It's really sick. He's already dead.
That's crossing the line.
Sorry.
None the worse for wear.
Bring on
love
the
that.
Now, here's the thing. I killed one, but the next one that shows up is going to be twice as hard.
Yeah, but still not hard.
Yeah.
We just got to get those jewels.
Yeah.
We're almost there. 286 feet.
Ted, you fucking scared the shit out of me.
Are you in the office?
Are you
delivering?
Even, are, that,
well,
are you,
you know
even
what?
Filming?
I'm, you know what? I'm not
oh
mad
my
because
God.
He's delivering us food.
You know what?
I'm not like, mad because he's delivering
hold
us food.
Hold on. I just want to point out, Ted,
yeah.
that in the middle of this
gosh,
filming...
What are you... Like,
you're making
yourself?
This look so unflattering.
Trying,
we both look so weird.
Are you trying to, like, narrate
oh
for the
God.
People watching?
God damn it, Ted. Shut the fuck
Ted.
Up,
Ted. Yes,
what
we do.
What are you doing?
Ted.
It's a real
Ted. Ted. Out.
What
you, get out.
You weren't even wearing a disguise. Help me put this on the table.
God damn it, Ted.
Before you wake it up.
Oh my God.
I have a question. Can I just fight this guy? Like, he's a hunt.
He's, like, not that bad.
I can take him.
There's no way.
Like, can I just fight him? Yeah, I can. Let's go. Let's go.
Hit him.
It won't let me. Yes. Yes, let's go.
I think he's just going to leave. I think he's literally just going to fly away. To entice you.
What a bummer. I was ready to fuck him up.
It's all good. He looks like a big ass turkey.
Let's go!
Oh! Alright, go get that gem. Oh god.
Let me fight him.
This weird crouch weirding me out.
Barely?
Barely?
I seriously thought we were at journey's end.
But that feat was fit for a king.
Indeed.
Yikes.
Anyways.
that was a bad joke. Oh my god.
I don't care. So now that I've changed outfits, I don't have infinite stamina, but there is a trick to sustaining your stamina.
Oh yeah, this is
so
a tight thing.
Yeah, as you run and it depletes.
You have so much stamina.
I know, right? So you're running, and when it gets to the last second, you let go and boom, full stamina and you boost run.
Yeah, it's great, like, way to just keep you engaged while you're running a long mm-hmm. distance. Everything about this game is so well designed.
Cue to call it a day.
All right, now we can drive back to Golden Key and give Dino his fucking stone that he extorted from us.
Let's yeah, go. So we could good. Technically go ahead and,
Whoa.
Damn.
We could hitbox porn.
We could have technically just fast traveled.
Yeah.
But like, I don't think that's a good vibe.
No way.
When it's so close, you know?
Yeah.
We're good. We're doing great.
Look at it. I feel like...
Well, I don't think I've ever seen Noctis stand on this car like this.
What? Really?
Yeah.
He does it all the time.
I have never once seen him stand on this car like this.
He does it all the time.
Never for me.
That's so weird.
He's... Look how fast we're going, and he's like, fuck yeah.
He's level 99. He doesn't have to worry. This is what level 99 life is
this
like.
This is what level 99's life
when
is
like. When
you're
level 99, you can fucking...
Do whatever you want?
You can... You don't have to worry about anything.
That's great.
You can't get any more powerful. That's it. Let's give Dino back his fucking stone.
We're gonna give Dino back his stone.
Here we are.
Dingo nice. Ate the baby.
Oh my god. Dino ate the baby.
Dino ate the baby.
Dino ate the baby. Beard Bros homework. Give me some fan art. Dino ate the baby. Using a PNG cutout of Dino from this game.
If like, there's one.
And make it look like he's eating a baby. You can make one in Photoshop. You can take a screen cap from this video. What?
That's so hard.
Guys, I'm not just giving you these homework assignments so that I can amuse myself and laugh at myself in my office.
I'm telling your parents.
I'm giving you these homework assignments so that you can learn something, like how to make a PNG in Photoshop. You want to know an easy way to do it? To make a shitty one?
Sure.
Go into Photoshop.
Yeah.
Put the photo in there.
Yeah.
Add another layer.
Yeah.
And cut out... The subject of the photo that you want to keep
yeah.
with the lasso tool.
Yeah.
Go up to select.
Yeah.
Hit inverse.
Yeah.
Press delete.
Yeah.
And then make the background file.
That's exactly what I do.
Yeah.
You know what? I want to see in Ted, film yourself teaching Bradley the same method. And if you don't know it, you're in trouble.
Do it as fast as you
and
can.
And show it right now. Go.
Do it as
go.
Fast as you go. Can. As go. Fast as you can. Go.
Brad, open Photoshop.
The PS?
Yeah. The Photoshop.
Right. Okay. Just on them.
Okay. And you're gonna wanna pick your image.
Okay.
I guess we could do the top one there.
Okay. That's fine.
And then grab the lasso tool.
Okay, it's
we're actually already on it, which is
okay.
Nice.
It's this thing. Okay.
Pick the image that you wanna cut out.
All right. I'm gonna cut out Jirard.
Okay. Just circle it, click and drag.
Click
all the way around his
head. Whoa, okay.
You know, you're good. That's pretty much it. Okay. And then you're going to want to go a little bit faster.
Oh, faster?
Yeah. That should do the trick. Nicely done. Okay. All right.
All right, and then do I connect it back, or do I just let go, or?
You don't let go. You can hold control.
Control.
And then click, and it'll connect it. And then go to select.
Where's this?
Yep, select. Up there, yeah. Okay. And inverse.
Okay.
And then hit delete.
All right, this one?
Actually, we might have to unlock the layer first.
How do I unlock the layer?
Oh, yeah, just click the unlock, or just click the lock.
Okay,
there we go.
Okay.
Now hit delete, that should work. And then make a new layer.
Okay.
Just maybe like any color or
any color. How do I put a color in?
You could grab the paint bucket, or you could make one of your layers just a solid color.
How do I do that?
You could click this.
This thing, the light and air mask?
No, the next one.
This?
Yep.
Okay.
And then solid color.
Okay.
And then pick like any color.
I like green.
Green, I love it.
Okay, so, okay, and then hit okay.
There you go. And so.
Thanks, man.
So Jirard's a PNG.
Thanks, Ted.
You're welcome.
Next time on Beer Bros.
Wait, just give Dino the stone.
Oh, okay, yeah, sorry.
Nice work, kid. Sorry for giving you such a hard time. I just had to get my hands on
Hey, sorry for blackmailing you, buddy.
Sorry for making you feel like shit before.
Hey, sorry for blackmailing you. Let me make it up to you. Come by and see me in the white. We'll cook you a home-cooked meal. Come on, go! It's a Master Charlie.
That special coin you got? It commemorates the Oracle's ascension. That guy was tossing them out to everyone.
So weird that he sounds like that. So weird.
Speaking of freebies, here's one from me. Come back if you want to buy more.
I doubt a souvenir like that could make its way into the hands of an ordinary citizen.
Oh well. To be fair, I wouldn't. That wouldn't be my first guess for Ignis's voice either. This time.
Next time on Beer Bros, we're gonna go. Going to get on the boat.
Yep.
Spoiler alert: we don't get on the boat.
You're welcome for the Photoshop lesson.
Bye.
Bye.
So dumb.